tell you that I have never met a man who I had better conversations with in my entire life. I know a lot of brilliant people, but I think Uncle is the most brilliant person I've ever met in my life. He was one of the most engaging conversationalists, and I think many of you have had that experience. We shared so much in life together, obviously. And the bond that I have, especially with Anita, I'm eternally grateful. And when I think of
Whenever he's sick, even though they moved from here to Orlando, he takes time to come over here, take care of him. Very nice of you to sing that song and express your feelings. Thank you very much. Now let me call upon Mr. Jimmy Alex, who is a former employee. Please.
Thank you. அவருக்கு மீண்டும் வருவார் என்று சொன்ன போனால் உங்களுக்கு கேட்டார் ആത്മ പ്രചോദനക്കാർ അനേകം പാട്ടുകൾ ഉപേക്ഷിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. അദ്ദേഹത്തിന് ഇഷ്ടമുള്ള ഒരു പാട്ട് പലപ്പോഴും നന്ദിയായി പാടിയ പാട്ട് അദ്ദേഹം വളരെ എൻ്റെ അടുത്ത് പറഞ്ഞ് വളരെ നന്ദിയുണ്ട്. സമയം കിട്ടുമ്പോഴൊക്കെ ഞാൻ ഈ പാട്ടിനെ കുറിച്ച് ചിന്തിക്കുകയും ആലോചിക്കുകയൊക്കെ ചെയ്യാറുണ്ടെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഈ പാട്ട് കുടുംബാംഗങ്ങൾക്കും അവരുടെ സന്തോഷത്തിനും അവരുടെ ഹൃദയത്തിലുള്ള വേദനകൾ മാറി കിട്ടുന്നതിന് വേണ്ടി ഞാൻ പാടും. എല്ലാവരെയും എനിക്ക് നിശ്ചയമില്ല എങ്കിലും എൻ്റെ മനസ്സിൽ ഓർമ്മയുള്ളത് മാത്രം ഞാൻ അത് പാടാം.
Please be seated. When the choir will sing the song at that time, you will have time for a viewing. We are going to wrap up the service on or before 8:30. So please patiently be seated. Next, may I call up Mr. Sreeraman Kochumurikil.
It is really a great privilege and honor for me to be here to celebrate the life of beloved Swami Sankaracharya. We are gathered here to say goodbye to our beloved Swami Sankaracharya and celebrate his life. Thank God for his wonderful life. Thank God for the great legacy he left with us. Once again, thank you Lord for letting him to reunite with his beloved wife Leela in heaven. It is our faith and belief that this is not the end. Yes, it is the end of a journey here in this world at the beginning of another journey to eternal life. I am sure that we all attending this service with a mixed feeling like me. I am glad that he is with the Lord where he belongs. There is no pain, no suffering, and no sorrow. On the other hand, I am sad that I am going to miss his smile, his love, and concerned about the fellow being and the physical presence. Last time, when Beloved Rajan Sakriya came to our church, I had the opportunity to sit down with him and all his family members and had a nice conversation. I never thought that it was the last chatting with him. I really shocked when I heard the unthinkable. It is really a void nobody can fill in. It is a great loss for Henry, Anita, Arun, grandkids, Renji, our church family, and the community at large. But it is a gain to heaven and Leela, who is waiting there with the open arms. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith, and for there is later for me a crown of righteousness. On behalf of Kropa City Prayer Group, myself and my family, I'd like to take this time to say condolence and deepest sympathy to Anita, Henry, Arun, grandkids, and all the grieving family. May the good Lord give you peace in the coming years to put through this difficult time.
Thank you, Joey. Now, may I call upon Professor Vivek Koshi, representing the Western Area Prayer.
Dear Rajan, pastors, members of the family, and friends, being asked to deliver a eulogy is a great honor, especially at the death of Rajan Sakriya Hamdan, a most loyal and devoted member of our church. Please do allow me to read this eulogy. It was with heartfelt grief, disappointment, and shock that we received news of his death last Thursday at the Baptist Hospital, Miami. The last time we saw him at church was two Sundays ago when he and his children were present. It was a special day for him and family as they were commemorating the first death anniversary of his dear wife. Never in our dreams did we realize that he would be taken away from us so soon. The one single thought that comes to my mind is that to salute this gentleman with a large heart who took care of the needs of the church when it was most needed. There is a song that was popular with the British soldiers during World War I. It was called, "Old Soldiers Never Die." In 1951, General Douglas MacArthur, decorated American war heroes, made a high-profile farewell address to a joint meeting of both houses of Congress. 65 years later, it gives me the honor of echoing the same words and emotions and thoughts about Rajanand. He did not die, he just faded away. He was a good soldier who fought a good fight, finished the race, and kept the faith. On behalf of the Western Area Prayer Group of the South Florida Mahatma Church, I hereby offer my deepest condolences to the grieving and bereaved family. May his soul rest in peace.
Thank you, Professor, for the question. We are almost coming to the end of the development. Now we will have a Bible reading and then Achin will give a short message and then we will have prayer and benediction and then more thanks. So it's the time. I want to say a couple of verses about our dear Rajanand. We had the building project. Going on last year and the beginning of this year. The Achin who was transferred from here, John Matthew Achin, he spent 3 days in prayer. And then Sunday, he announced to the church that we are short of some money. He never expected that such a miracle is going to happen. He said that we are short of $25,000. So there was a hand from the back said that, Achin, I will bring the money. Your God has blessed us. We, all of us are not poor. But how many of us will have the courage to say that I will write a check for $25,000. Nobody trusting, no compulsion at all. It is from the bottom of the heart. A good-hearted person, a loving person, a caring person who always look for the welfare of the people. We are so grateful to the family, and it's a big loss for the Mahatma Church, and it's a big loss for our Malayali community. I want to express our deepest condolences to the grieving family. Now we will have a Psalm reading, Psalm 90, and then Achin will the message and we'll close the prayer.
You turn people back.
song which we heard just now is also requested by Ram Gaur Rajanagar before his death, really his farewell time. Almost we come to the end of this wake ceremony. I reach in South Florida last Wednesday when we were sitting in our house. Our trustee, Rajiv Engel, was telling me, actually, if you are free, tomorrow we will go to, again we will go to Miami to visit one of our members who is admitted in hospital. And I agreed to him, we will go tomorrow by 4:30 to the hospital. The next day morning, one of my members phoned me and told me that Rajanagar is just fine. I don't know anything about Rajanagar, but I heard from our friends that he was a man of hope. Also, he was a man of mercy to the poor, those who are needy. He was always with them. In our lifetime, we have to accept four kinds of calls from our God. Devan vilikkunna naalu viligal naam kelkkuvan eppozhum irukkumallo. First call, he is calling us from the mud, that is birth. Manilana Devanana vilikkunnu. ഈ ജനനത്തിലും കരച്ചിലും ഉണ്ട് സന്തോഷം when we are waiting for the child's birth, we all are anxious about whether we are hearing the cry of a child. When we hear the child's cry, child's crying, all those who are waiting for the new baby, their faces will brighten. ഒരു കുഞ്ഞിൻ്റെ ജനനം നടക്കുമ്പോൾ കുഞ്ഞ് കരയുമ്പോഴാണ് മാതാപിതാക്കളിലും അത് കാത്തു നിൽക്കുന്ന എല്ലാവർക്കും സന്തോഷം ഉണ്ടാകുന്നത്. അതുകൊണ്ട് ജനനത്തിലും കരച്ചിലുണ്ട്, സന്തോഷവും. അതാണ് ദൈവം വിളിക്കുന്ന ഒന്നാമത്തെ. ദ നെക്സ്റ്റ് കോൾ ഫോർ റീബർത്ത്. ദൈവം നമ്മിൽ നിന്ന് പ്രതീക്ഷിക്കുന്നു, ഗോഡ് എക്സ്പെക്ട് അസ് ടു ലീഡ് എ ഗുഡ് ലൈഫ് അക്കോർഡിംഗ് ടു ഹിസ് വിഷ്. ദൈവം നമ്മെ വിളിക്കുന്ന രണ്ടാമത്തെ വിളി പുതുജീവനിലേക്ക്, നിത്യജീവന്റെ അനുഭവത്തിലേക്ക്, ഒരു മടങ്ങി വരവിന്റെ അനുഭവത്തിലേക്ക് ദൈവം നമ്മെ വിളിക്കുന്നു. ആ വിളിയും നാം സ്വീകരിക്കാൻ ഇപ്പോഴും ഒരുക്കമുള്ളതായിരിക്കും. മൂന്നാമത്തെ വിളിയാണ് ഡെത്ത്. ഹി ഓൺലി ഗിവൻ ദ ലൈഫ് ടു അസ് and he has full freedom to call back. Devan namme vilikkan vilikkunnathaya vili ethu samayathaanu ennu namukku ariyuvanayi kazhiyilla. Naan devan namme vilikkumbol santoshathodu athu kodukkuvanayittu namukku kazhiyum. Ee maranathilum chiriyum undu karachilum undu ennu njan parayunnu. Kaaranam മുമ്പേ ഇതിനു മുൻപേ പ്രസംഗിച്ചു പോയ ആളുകൾ പറഞ്ഞ് ഞാൻ കേട്ടു, ഈ ലോകത്തിൻ്റെതായിട്ടുള്ള കഷ്ടപ്പാടുകളും മെച്ചപ്പാടുകളും വേദനയും പെയിനും ഒന്നുമില്ലാത്തതായ അനുഭവത്തിലേക്ക് ആ വ്യക്തി മാറ്റപ്പെട്ടു പോകും. ഇയർ ബഡ്സിന്, കൂടെയുള്ളവർക്ക്, മക്കൾക്ക് എല്ലാം ഒരു വേദനയുടെ രാശിയുടെ അനുഭവം. എങ്കിലും അവിടെയും ഒരു കരച്ചിലും ഒരു സന്തോഷവുമുണ്ട്. എന്നാൽ ദൈവം നാലാമതായിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു വിളി, ആ വിളി നാം എല്ലാവരും സ്വീകരിക്കാനായിട്ട് ഒരുക്കുമുള്ളതായിരിക്കും. രാജ്യങ്ങളെ സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം ആദ്യത്തെ മൂന്ന് വിളികൾ സ്വീകരിച്ചു. മണ്മയമായുള്ള ഈ ലോകത്തിലേക്ക് രാജ്യങ്ങളിലെ ദൈവം ജന്മത്തിലൂടെ വിളിച്ചു. ജൻ
ജീവിതാനുഭവങ്ങളിൽ കർത്താവിന് വേണ്ടി പുതുക്കമുള്ള ആളായിട്ട് പ്രവർത്തിച്ചു. സമയമായപ്പോൾ കർത്താവ് മൂന്നാമത്തെ പുള്ളി സ്വീകരിച്ച് ഈ ലോകത്ത് നിന്ന് മാറ്റിക്കൊണ്ടു. ഇന്നല്ലെങ്കിൽ നാളെ നമ്മൾ ഈ ഒരു വിളി സ്വീകരിക്കാനായിട്ട് ഒരുക്കമുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. എന്നാൽ ഏറ്റവും പ്രധാനം ജീവനോടെ ഇരിക്കുന്ന ഒന്നാമതൊരു വിളി, നാലാമത്തെ വിളിക്ക് വേണ്ടി ഇവിടെ ആയിരിക്കുമ്പോൾ തന്നെ ഒരുങ്ങുക, ആ വലിയ വിളിയാണ് ദൈവം നമ്മളിൽ നിന്ന് പ്രതീക്ഷിക്കുന്ന. ആ വിളിയെ ഒരിക്കലും നഷ്ടപ്പെട്ടു പോകാനായിട്ടില്ല. ദൈവകൃപയോട് ജീവിക്കുവാൻ വേണ്ടി നമുക്ക് കഴിയും. So called from birth as a birth, called for rebirth, and called from this world that is death, and there will be a call for eternity. When I hear the condolence messages, I understood that. Rajnikal was a man of great hope. As Richard Engel memorized Rajnikal's life, he said he never missed church activities and church service in his life. So that's why I will say he already accepted the second call from Jesus Christ. Let's thank God for Rajnikal's good life. Dear Henry, dear Anita, you had a role model before you. Your father lived a good life according to Jesus' will, according to God's will. Try to follow your father's path, because we all have to accept the God's call for eternity. On behalf of South Florida Martha Church and all those Martha made city, and on my behalf, I express hearty condolence to Rajan and his family, especially every Amanita, Arvind children. May God continue to bless you, comfort you, console you. Thank you. Let's all stand for the call. Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. And the blessing of the Triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and among you, and keep us from all evil, and make us worthy of all good gift.
Amen.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Now the choir will sing. Now before the choir sing the song, I wonder, Anita and Anita come and say the word of thanks. After that, the choir will sing a song. By the time, you can go and show the last respect. And tomorrow, we will have the final service at the Martha Church of South Florida at 10 a.m. Please come and show the last respect there also. Anita and Henry, please.
First of all, thank you very much for coming out here today. I want to first of all thank a couple of people here. Brian Jacob, thank you very much for helping with that pamphlet. And Sue and Mohan for the Carmelites and just support in general. The George family, greatly appreciate it, you know, for years. You know. And I want to thank Reggie for taking the time. Been traveling for 6 weeks straight, and she still came out to help my father. You know, she had not slept in her own bed for 6-7 weeks, and she came here, you know, out of her pure love for my father to help him out. Yeah, she was very instrumental in bringing my family to the U.S. and actually introducing my mother and father together. So, if it wasn't for her, you know, we wouldn't be here today, and most people would not even know about us, or it would never have existed. So thank you. You know, one thing I do want to say, when they played the John Lennon song, the first time I ever saw my father really cry, it was like in 1980 in Brooklyn, when the founder of John Lennon had passed away. You know, he was very influenced by that man because he was a visionary. And visionaries recognize other visionaries, just like you said, Sheila. You know, and he was greatly influenced by that. You know, he paved his own path. He, you know, he walked and danced to his own beat that was unique to most people. He lived a life that most people could only wish they could live. You know, because know, he was not a man that was consumed by fear. You know, he engaged. And he just went out there and he's such a rough return, punched them in the mouth. So he just did what he had to do. And he made it, you know. And in the end, you know, we did our best, but he was so focused on getting back and being with mom. And he, you know, once he was focused on that objective, he was not going to stop. So I'm actually happy that he's back with her. So once again, thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Henry and Nida. Now, the choir will sing a song, and at that time, you know, you can come and go to the last of it and walk out. And I wanted to express our thanks to the choir. You know that today is a working day. They have rushed